What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I'm Blake McLain, and I'm a music producer. So I'm doing Olivia Rodrigo twice in a row because I literally asked for this in the last video. I said I wanted to see Good For You live, and in the comments, everyone was like, she's doing it on SNL, she's doing it on SNL. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. I've been waiting for this, and I'm so excited. Wanted to wait until Monday, though, because the weekend's a little crazy. Also, I just wanted to thank you guys so much for watching that last video so much that it ended up actually trending. It was 19 on trending, which is so cool. It's unbelievable. So, and if you do like this video and you like the channel, all that stuff, please press subscribe. There's actually a little like subscribe watermark now on the video. If you hover over it, there's a subscribe button on there. So please subscribe. And if you want extra content too, check out the Patreon. I've got tons of stuff on there, and actually today I'm going to be breaking down this song in depth on there, like completely breaking it down, lyrics, all that stuff. And yeah, that's pretty much all that stuff. And please follow me on social media as well. That'll be somewhere on the screen for a second. So anyways, that's pretty much all that stuff. So let's jump in. Let's go. So this is Olivia Rodrigo, Good For You, live from SNL. All right, let's go. Kill it.
Once again, Olivia Rodrigo!
You moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? And good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the therapist I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man.
Also, there's like nothing on her vocal at all. It's super dry here, which is cool. And it just goes to show like how talented you have to be in order to do that. I mean, she's absolutely incredible because there's nothing on it. There's nothing to mask, like little tiny mess ups or anything like that. For example, if you put a bunch of reverb on it, really and truly, it kind of masks sometimes like little bit of pitch issues or anything like that. And there's no real tune on her vocal either.
You brand new girl.
What's up with the band? Like, come on. Get into it a little bit. Okay, she's getting into it a little bit on the left. That bassist needs to start going a little crazy, though. Like, throw your bass around, man. I want to see someone do, like, a full spin. Come on. We used to try those when I was, like, younger. We'd go out in the yard with, like, our guitars, got strap locks, and just try to do, like, the spin over the shoulder with it. That kind of a thing. It ended up bad a couple times. Not gonna lie.
I guess you're getting everything you want. You bought a new car and your career's really taking off. It's like we never even happened, baby. What the is up with that? And good for you, it's like you never even met me. Remember when you swore to God I was the only person who ever got you? Well, screw that, screw you. You will never have to hurt the way you know that I do. Good for you, you look happy as hell. If you ever care to ask. Good for
you. Know, this is actually a perfect opportunity too for me to talk about something. Live performances. One of the reasons I love it when there are natural instruments, you know, I'll call them like naturalistic instruments. You have, you know, real bass, real guitar, all that stuff, is you get a better experience live than you actually do when listening to the recording. Because whenever you do record all those instruments and stuff like that, you end up kind of compressing everything down and you lose a little bit of the quality and stuff like that live. That's why recording is such an art. You know, you're trying to capture the sound that you hear in the room and get it perfect. And there's some extra things you can do to it and stuff like that. But that's also why when you hear it live, it sounds so much better because that's how it was meant to sound. That's how it was written, you know? And so it just gives you this whole different feeling. And I love that about this. Also, they are using like a backing track. They did at the very beginning, unless, they might have just threw that out the window after that. I doubt it. So the way that this works is if there's a backing track, so there's like a synth going on or something like that in the background, is they have the backing track playing and then the drummer is playing to a click track. So all the drummer hears is that kind of a thing. Everybody plays to the drummer. That way everything stays perfectly on time, which is pretty cool. There she goes. She's giving a little bit.
Maybe I'm too emotional. Maybe you'll never get it all. Maybe I'm too emotional. Apathy is like a wound inside.
I really want that kick though on that, especially live. Let me bring it back just a tad. So right here. Ready? Maybe you'll never get it all. Maybe I'm too emotional. Apathy is like a wounded soul. And maybe a couple just nice hits on the snare, you know, doom, doom, ka, doom, doom, that kind of a thing. So it just feels like it's building even more. That's just something you can kind of do live to give it even more oomph than the recording. Too emotional. They must be friends. Maybe he's not used to playing on stage. That might be it, you know. That might be why he's just a little bit sort of nervous and, you know, kind of timid about the whole thing. But it'll come eventually. And honestly, guys, one of the reasons I'm so excited about this whole thing is because I grew up playing in bands and all that stuff. And, like, local shows have kind of gone out of, I don't know, out of style, that kind of a thing. And, like, we used to go and, you know, we'd all play on the weekends. All my friends were in bands and stuff like that. And everyone would go out to shows and everyone would play. And that just kind of died after a while. And so it's so cool to see something like this happen from somebody that has the opportunity to make it happen.
Hey everyone, so I actually just went to go import my footage and realized that my camera cut off at the very last second. So I just wanted to thank you guys again for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. And until next time, I'll catch y'all later.